Both of my sons have molybdenum cofactor deficiency type A, but their journeys are very different.
Molybdenum cofactor deficiency is a group of rare genetic disorders, and untreated leads to irreversible significant brain damage and early death.
My older son, Jihad, he wasn't correctly diagnosed till we came to Nationwide Children's Hospital in 2021.
They had been told all of their lives that this wasn't a genetic condition. When I reviewed the history with his mother, it was very clear there was actually a genetic cause. We pursued exome sequencing, which we do have here, and confirmed the diagnosis. Once you know the diagnosis in the family, our obstetrical colleagues have the capability of confirming the diagnosis during pregnancy. They ultimately confirm the diagnosis for the second pregnancy. And upon confirmation, the family was referred to our fetal center.
Although the diagnosis with my second son was heartbreaking, there was a hope.
In 2021, the FDA approved a drug after doing a small trial that showed effectivity in reducing the mortality in these kids.
I was happy because there's a treatment, something we could do, could save your baby from brain injury.
It's really important to get these patients when things are happening from the beginning. We're seeing in real time the progression of diseases prenatally, so we can start acting and change the trajectory. In the second MRI at 28 weeks, we started seeing some changes in some of the normal spaces of the brain. We sat down with our team and the parents and designed a plan to deliver the baby electively at 32 weeks to protect the brain. We are balancing the risk of the progression of the disease with the risk of prematurity.
I didn't think twice. I really trusted them.
We had newborn nurse practitioners in the delivery room who were able to place a central line for him so that we could start giving that medication through his umbilical cord.
This is the earliest treatment of a baby with molybdenum cofactor.
Ghaith? Hello.
We were able to attack the disease before there was significant damage.
The partnering that we did with maternal fetal medicine with geneticists and neurologists means that we get to optimize care and create the most evidence-based and medically innovative care plans for newborns with medical complexity. That very large one-team approach allowed for us to send home a little boy who very likely will continue to be impacted by his disease, but who hopefully will continue to grow and thrive because we minimize the risks.
I told them, if there is more than 5 stars, I will give it to you. This drug keeps my son alive. He's able to smile, laugh. He's social. He drinks his bottle, no seizures. He's improving. His brain is growing. One of the reasons that we moved from New Jersey, it was Nationwide Children's Hospital. I feel they are my second family.
We are pushing the envelope and pushing forward medical care. There was not a surgery or a medical intervention that needed to be physically performed for Ghaith, but knowing that a medication could be given within the first minutes of life was what we had to offer. Ghaith's care was also significantly impacted by our knowledge of his disease because of the diagnosis that Dr. Chaudhry made for Ghaith's brother, Jihad.
The Genome Institute was instrumental in order to care for a baby with a known or suspected rare disease. You've got to have excellence in maternal fetal medicine, excellence in fetal imaging, a world-class neonatal intensive care unit, access to genome sequencing, access to experts in rare diseases, which we have in spades here at Nationwide Children's Hospital.
He's a genius. I think he's just a gem. He had the most knowledge about this diagnosis. If Jihad doesn't receive or take in this treatment right now, probably he's not with us today. Ghaith, hopefully he's helping other babies. He's the first one in the whole world who started that treatment that early, and it saved him from brain injury. There is a very big difference between both of them, but we are blessed to have both of them. They are my heroes.